You can hear me, okay?
Yes.
Alright, I realize that every story that I tell is depressing. And while I was sitting there listening, I was like, I have a really fun brush with fame story, and I'm not telling that one today. Okay, and I did a brush with death one before, but we missed it. Sorry. Okay. 1984, Hamburg, Germany. And I am a newbie model. So it was like a long freaking time ago, like 37 years ago. And I am in an odd situation with a man. He just wanted to have sex with me. And odd as that may sound, I was shocked. Because I was 20, and he was in his early 30s, which at the time I thought was really gross, because I was 20, and he was 32 and married. And for me, that was like gross, like dad age. And But I really was surprised. And this guy was a rock star. And you might think that I was silly. So call me fresh off the boat from Missouri, because I was. You can call me Pollyanna. So my friend Jean and I were living in Germany, and we've been modeling there for a couple months. And so when you're a model, what you do all day long, you might have heard of this term called go-sees. So you're kind of out on the streets all day long, and you're talking to photographers and clients, and you're like looking for a job, much like you would if you were, I don't know, a musician or an actor. And so all day long you listen to music. So back in 1984 you had like foam headphones, and you had your Sony Walkman, because like you're cool, and you had cassettes, not CDs or whatever, MP, well, there was no such thing as an MP3. So you're also really poor. So I had three cassettes. I had David Bowie, I had The Police, and I had this singer guy. We'll just call him Singer Man and the Band. Okay? And if anybody knows me, you know, like, music is my thing. Music probably brings me more joy than, well, okay, your kids and the people that you love, but whatever. Okay, music is my thing. And then when you, you know, when you spend so much time with music, like 8 hours a day with music, and you only have three cassettes, I knew every word to every song. And oh my God, he was coming to Hamburg, Germany. And if you've ever lived abroad, you know that you are hungry for things that are, you know, from home, right? And so I was so excited. So we got two general admission tickets, and my friend Jean and I were like front and center. So here he is, like this, singing. And here I was, like you, right? And so I was like, you know, right there, and I'm like, whatever, I'm singing. Well, it was not quite this, well, it probably was this dorky, but yeah, so I'm like knowing every word and I'm singing, because I, as you can tell, I'm kind of fast and loose. Well, I'm really not, but you know. So I was joyful. I mean, I was joyful, and it was probably the best nights of my life, because I was 20, and I really was fresh off the boat from Missouri, and it was like a concert, and he was right there, and I knew all the words, and all the Germans, they were freaking clueless, because they were like, who's this guy? Anyway. So after the show, this guy comes out, he takes me and Jean backstage, and then we're backstage, and then next thing you know, we're on the tour bus, and then next thing you know, we're like at the hotel, and I'm thinking like, it's time to party, right? Because like, this is like the most exciting night of my freaking life, and so this is what, it's party. I didn't realize that for them, it was just another night on the road. And so we get into the hotel lobby, and everybody scatters, and I lose my friend Jean, and next thing you know, I'm in the elevator with Singer Man and some road crew people. And I'm thinking like, And then floor by floor, the road crew people get off the elevator. And now it's just me, it's the singer guy from my foam headphones, he and I in the elevator. And then he gets to his floor and he walks out, and then I walk out and he walks to down the hall. And you know the situations where it's awkward and you don't really know what to say, and so you just say like the most dumbass thing ever? Well, that's what I said, like something really dumb. I said, so where's all the fans to mob you? And he went, I don't know, but you can mob me if you want. And I just went, you know, like a stupid girl laugh, but whatever. So I did some stupid laugh. So he goes to his door, and he opens his room door, and I followed him in. And he's probably wondering, okay, what is she doing in here? And I'm probably wondering, what am I doing in here? But honestly, I was so excited. Like, I can talk to him. Like, this guy that's been singing in my head for months, and he can give me some really cool story, and I can take it home to my friends. And so I told him how much I loved the concert, and he was honest with me then. And he was like, thank you so much. It was so great that you were there front and center. I had something to perform for. And so I do believe that he was being honest. And now it was his turn to say something really stupid. He goes, all I ask is for one thing, a kiss. I've never been kissed. And before I could say or do anything, his mouth was on mine, his tongue was down my throat, and his hands were on my ass. And I was just like, and so when that was done, I just didn't really know what to say or do. And I just went, where's everybody else? So my mind was still looking for, there must be a party somewhere. And so he mentioned the name of a room. I left, I went to that room. And the guy that got us backstage was in there with a prostitute, because prostitution is legal in Hamburg, Germany, and they weren't having sex, they were talking. That's another story. Anyway, in about a minute, the phone rings in that room, and it's Singer Man. And he's asking for me. And so I was like, hello. And he's like, hey, I've got to go out with the promoter until like 2 a.m. Can I, you know, catch up with you when I get back? And like, okay, I might be fresh off the boat, but I'm not a moron. I knew what he was asking for. And so I lied and I said, no, I have a shoot early tomorrow morning, so I have to go. And so I hung up, went down to the lobby. I couldn't find my friend Jean, got a taxi, went home. But I was still like on this adrenaline high, and I used a lot of money, like Deutsche Marks, called home, talked to my boyfriend. Oh my God, I just met Singer Man. Woo, I was all excited and whatever. And then the next day came, and I was gonna journal, because I journaled all the time then, but I couldn't write. The only thing I could do was cry. I was, oh my God, I was devastated. It was honestly the first time in my life that I ever felt like, you mean this person didn't want to get to know me? Like, oh my, it was awful. Like, I thought he was gonna be like the nicest guy, and he had reduced me to just, I don't know, parts, sexual parts. And he had no desire to know me at all. I was devastated for days, I cried. And I know I still have a journal somewhere. So let's just say that this Singer Man does not know anything about the power of love. And he definitely is not the heart of rock and roll. The end!